Today's video is going to be about, it's a how-to video, and it's going to be about how to change that oil, how to do a PM service, which is changing oil and fuel filters on 2012 Freightliner Cascadia. With that being said, let's get to work. I'll be showing you step by step how to get all this done, and so you can do it yourself. I'm an owner operator driver, so it's always good to save money here and there to get some stuff done yourself. If you got tools and common sense, you can get this stuff done by yourself. Okay, so to get started, you remove this cap over here, and then also, I already did that last night, but you remove this filter over here. There will be a filter in here. I removed it last night because I drained the oil last night. So you remove the cap, remove the filter. Then you go over here. I already drained it last night because I like to drain it. I like to drain it over the night, that way it drains down really good. Now what I'm gonna do is close it off and start putting a new filter in and start putting new oil in there. So originally it'll come like with a bolt in there where you gotta unscrew it with a ratchet. But I installed this oil drain thing where it's easier to drain your oil. As you see, I don't know if you can see it, but this thing is full of oil, so I'm gonna pull it out. This thing ready to come out. And it's full of oil. That's about 11 gallons in here. Now it's time to install this filter. Don't forget to always install this new seal kit on this thing over here. I'll show it to you in a second. So this thing will have this this rubber seal. Take this one off and go ahead and put a new one in there. The new seal is in. I like to put a little bit of oil on it where it slides good in that when you turn it in, where it slides in good. This side right here goes into the cap first, get it in a place where it clips in place. There you go. Now we are ready. Don't do it too hard because this is plastic caps. If you overdo them, you're probably gonna damage the thread and start leaking oil. And we're just gonna, when it, you can feel it stop, and that's pretty much it. So the filter is in. Now it's time to put in some fresh oil. It takes about 10 and a half to 11 gallons for a 2012 Detroit DD15. So I usually buy four 2.5 gallon jugs, and I buy one more that has 1 gallon, that makes 11 gallons. So I'm gonna put it in. What I like to do, you get your oil in, filter in, your oil in, put it in the cap, make sure everything's good, nothing's leaking anymore. And what I like to do, I like to start up the truck before I change my fuel filters. That way it's been drained over the night, so if all the oil is pretty much 100% drained. And when you go ahead and change the fuel filters before you start the truck, the whole head and everything is dry. So you know how it is when you usually change the fuel filters. It'll take a little bit for the truck to start. So to avoid that churning on the dry head and all that, I usually start the truck before I change the fuel filters. That way it's already greased up and pretty much ready to go. So let's crank it up, let it run for a few minutes, shut it back down and do the filter change. We'll let it run for a few minutes, got it back off, and we'll be doing the fuel filters. Okay, so the truck ran for a few minutes. We got it good greased up and stuff. Now it's time to change fuel filters. And what you do, you come over here, unscrew this bad boy over here, unscrew this thing. That's three on 2012. I got three filters, and I believe 2013 and up, maybe 2014 and up, they eliminated this one, and you got only two. On the older one, you got three filters. Plus, you got this water separator. I don't need to change it yet, because the change line is all the way over here. I don't know if you can read that, it says over here, change. But I'll go ahead and do it on this video so you can guys know how to do the full PM service on your truck. So what you do, come over here and you unscrew this top cap and go down here and drain that fuel. Sometimes a lot of dirt will come out from there. So you just drain it. And you gotta have this tool over here to be able to remove this huge flange over here. So I just put it on there like this. That's on a Freightliner. Also on other stores too. So I remove this filter, and then we'll go to the other stuff. Filter was removed, I cleaned the inside of it. Now we need to go back over there and take off these filters over here. Just for your info, you cannot use no impact guns or nothing like that. You gotta use a manual ratchet to do it with your hand. If these things are plastic, you will damage it with the gun. time to install this water separator filter. Always replace these O-rings with the new ones that's provided with the filters. And be sure you will put this O-ring over here, not on this side of the lip. Like when you're gonna put this in there, make sure this O-ring not between the flange and the thing itself. Make sure it's on the other side of the curve where this will go down and seal off over here. Don't do it too tight, just nice and firm. Make sure you take off this plastic and the ring that comes with it, the O-ring. Make sure you take off this old one every time you do an oil change. When you put this in there, you need to hear that clip. There you go. That goes back together over here like this. You gotta hear that clip. If you don't hear that clip, it's not in there. This thing, I actually bought a new one because mine has a big crack in here. Cap, just in case you need that part number. Here's the part number. I don't know, I'll show you both sides. Alright, this is it. Now we're ready to screw them in. Alright, so this one's ready to go in here. By the way, these caps take 36 millimeter socket. Just in case you're wondering. That's all I need. It doesn't need to be too tight. What I like to do is to put a clean diesel into the water separator and into that bigger filter that I got. That way it's easier to start up the truck later. Now the main problem is this right here. Do not forget to put this ring on this stop cap, because I did it one time and I had a really hard time this truck running. Put this on there and now the biggest trick of this whole thing, you gotta pump this about 400 times.
you should be able to start pretty quick. If I can find my keys, I don't know where to go. Probably on the other side of the truck. I like to turn on the ignitions two or three different times, and all that way the pump will pump in some fuel into itself too. Give it a try. About 3 seconds. And I got it running. 3 to 5 seconds. That's all it turned. So after we do the oil change, the fuel filter change, and crank it up, let it work for a little bit, shut it back off, check for all the leaks, pull out the dipstick, level on the dipstick is good, it's at the top level. That's perfect. Now what we need to do is grease up the truck. Locate all the grease points, which will be over here. And then there's gonna be one over here. One over here on the kingpin. There's gonna be one on top, one on the bottom, then over there on that steering column bushing, there's gonna be one too on the brake chamber, on the S cam over here you're gonna have one here, not the brake chamber, the slack adjuster, you're gonna have one on the slack adjuster. Same thing on the other side. Same thing here. Kingpin, top and bottom. Then the that thing over there, turning the wheel, that bushing over there, slack adjuster. And then you got one on the transmission on the bottom there. On the Cascadias, I think most of the Cascadias, you gotta do the drive shaft. Volvos, their drive shaft is sealed. But the Cascadias, you gotta grease up each turning point, which is over here. Then you got one over here. Then one farther down, all the yokes, it has the grease points. And you go over here on the S cams, on the S cam, and on the slack adjuster. You gotta grease it up really good. I usually try to do it every time I do my oil change. It's not that I try to do it every time I do oil change. Sometimes I'll do one in between. It never hurts to keep your truck greased up really good. So let's go underneath there. Oh, usually what I try to do, I'll set up these ramps over here in the front of the tires, and we'll drive up with the truck on them. That way I have more clearance on the bottom to ride around on that mechanic cart to grease it up. We'll be right back. like to use, I like to use this DeWalt grease gun. And I'll tell you guys, I love this thing. This thing will get your job done much faster, and this battery will last forever. I mean, I had this truck for about 2 years. I charged this battery maybe twice or three times, because it doesn't take much at all of this battery to grease up your truck. So if you have equipment, machinery that you want, that you're supposed to grease up, I'd recommend it is DeWalt grease gun or Milwaukee. Milwaukee is a really good brand too. But this DeWalt, I just love it. It does the job. It makes the job so much easier. So let's get under here and start greasing it up. We got one on the grease box. You got a fitting on the grease box, don't forget to do it. So it's kind of hard to record and grease at the same time, so I'm just gonna go over the greasing points. There's one right here, so you can see them. This is on this steering linkage that's going to the gearbox. And then you got one over here. Kind of dark, but over here on the slack adjuster, and then you got one on the kingpin on the bottom, then you one on the kingpin on top, then on this steering column on the ends on these tie rods, whatever they call, you got one here, then you got one here. This one right here is very important one. Let me see if I can find it right here. This one's going up there into your transmission, and it comes down here, and here it is. You gotta grease this one up. But guys, don't do this one too hard, I mean too much, and not very hard. Just, you know, if you're doing the automatic grease gun like I have, don't full throttle that thing, because you know, I might bust the seal out or something. Just take it easy on this one, and don't do it too much, maybe two or three pumps, because if you do it too much, your clutch will start spinning. It's not gonna engage the right way. So two or three pumps, that's all you need every time you do your PM service. All right, so we go on this side also. You got one here on the kingpin bottom and top, and slack adjuster. On the driver, on the passenger side, you got only four greasing points. On the driver side, you got a little bit more, like six or seven, I think. All right, so let's keep going this way. Go to your drive shaft. You got one in there. See it? There's one in there. Keep coming this way. You got one in there. Right there. Keep going this way. You got one in here. And the last one, you got one here on the drive shaft. Then you go farther underneath here. You got one on the slack adjuster and one on the S-cam over there. You got two nipples, grease nipples per side on the drive axles. So it'll be two nipples on the passenger drive front, passenger drive rear, and then same thing, you know, driver side, front left, and driver side rear left. Got two greasing points on these. So get out of here. And that's all you do for a PM service. I'm gonna put this phone down right now, and I'll start greasing up this truck. And that'll be it for this video. Hope you learned something. Like and subscribe. We'll see you next time. Now that I changed my oil, we need to recycle it the proper way. Don't be one of those people just to go dump it in the woods somewhere. I got this 15-gallon cart for the oil, and it has electric pump on it. Some of them come with manual pumps. Just stick it in there. Flip it on.